if we can craft a few more stone stuff, try to get to level 30 on our way, also to 35 so we get the pteranodons tamed. I'm just going to collect a few things while I'm running here. I'm nearly out of water. Once we get over to these berry bushes, maybe I'll have our buddy Glue fix that for us. Here you go, girl. What are you doing? Get over here. Alright, so we'll pop on her. She just leveled up. That's what that was about. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and drink through berry. Hold that down. And why don't we stick it in... You want to do weight or health? Let's keep you alive. So we're going to pop another 70 health on you. And the reason she freaked out was not because she was eating or leveling. It was because she was pooping. That poop gave her the next level. Alright, so these two trees right here, I'm going to bring Glue closer. And we'll go ahead and take out these two trees. Get some thatch. And we're pretty heavy here. I'm just going to navigate her down the rock. Alright, so we've got a stone raft over here. And the reason I'm messing around with this raft is because I want to get us to a point where we can get some of those nifty beaver dams. And so what I've done here is I've laid out some foundations. We got six foundations across here. I'm going to go ahead and drink real quick. Pushing the E key while standing in the water. Glue, you can stop following me for a moment. Alright, so I put these holes right here so that I can, you know, lay down and then pick up anything we run over as far as beaver dams. And if I happen to fall out and I pick up the beaver dam while I'm getting attacked by all those beavers, this is a hardcore server. I don't want to die because then, you know, basically starting all over level 1. But if I just push E while I'm outside there, it pops me right back in the boat. So any part of the boat you push E on throws you into drive. So you can see I've got no driver tiller area right here open to me. So it's hard for me to hit the E button while I'm back here. It says hold for options, because that's giving me the foundation selection. But if I hit anywhere on the boat, I'll pop up, I'll be inside the boat, and then we can go ahead and start crafting whatever. We can throw some walls on here too, but yeah, that'll be a nice raft to get started. And I'm thinking I might even extend out a little bit here in the backside. Give the boat a little bit more length, and that way I can have a box around me once I jump in here. So for that I'm going to need some roof tiles. And so right now we need stone and we need wood. I do have quite a few walls on this puppy, so why don't we go ahead and lay those down. We got some stone as well. So here are the walls. We got six of them. Got a fair amount of stone. Thanks, Cotton. Cotton's a tribe mate that I think he collected some stone here. I'm gonna snag it. And I'm not sure if I want to put a wall on the back side because I think I'm gonna extend that out some. So I'm gonna put these walls here for now. And so my thought would be to make a doorway leading out here so I can come out on the front side of it and collect, and then leave these hatches open so that you know, I don't have to worry about extra pieces going there. Just leave that open, and then I'll have either walls or doorway, at least one doorway here. And I might go too high as well to give myself some room for other things. But I'm thinking I want some ceiling tiles laid out here on the back side. And I might even do a ramp going down and allowing for a dinosaur to ride inside. So that would be a 3 high. So let's go ahead and start collecting. We're going to get Glue to follow us again. We want to have some protection while we're out here. We've got a Pelignormus here. Let's go ahead and kill this birdie. So you bolo the birds and then you stab them in the face. Alright, and that'll give us some hide and some raw meat too. Hey, very nice. Alright, so we're going to just run around here spamming that E button, getting as much stone as we can. And then we're going to make our way over to some trees and get the wood. And that should be what we need to craft some of those ceiling tiles. I think we have just about enough to make 3 ceiling tiles. And it's kind of funny that the big trees give less wood than some of these smaller ones. Look at how much wood you get out of this thing. It's crazy. This one must have been hit by something or someone. That's why it fell over so quick. Okay. So at any point, being a hardcore server, other players might come up and sneak up on us here. We also might run into some carnivores and whatnot. It's probably more likely to get hit by raptors and carnotaurus than it is to buy another player. On the hardcore server, there aren't as many people playing. I'm actually looking to try to get a community going here on this server. It'd be nice to have more players. Alright, so we're going to want to get more ceiling tiles. Let's go back and get the stone off of the trike. Also grab the thatch if we've got any here. 64, some stone. And we can demolish this stuff here. Let's go ahead and lay this down and demolish. Then take the whole thatch house. Came off of a drop. This will just be probably a slow way of collecting resources here. So I'm laying it down. I lay it down the same location. It breaks it and gives it back. So, no, I did not want to make more of them. But that's the risk we run into. Alright, so I'm going to do that one more time. And then I'm going to put the doorway frame here. Alright, and then we can also put the roof and do very similar actions there. And then, let's see, we'll finish off with the door. Go ahead and use that. So this got us a little bit of thatch, a little bit of fiber back as we were demolishing. We can demolish the rest in just a moment. And then we got some ceiling tiles. We want three. We got three. They're building. And let's go ahead and demolish the door while we're working on this. And we don't want to demolish the door frame or the foundation until we get the ceiling done, so we'll go ahead and demolish that. Problem with demolishing a supporting structure like this wall here before demolishing the roof is it would break the roof, but you would not get any resources back. So we're going to go ahead and demolish that as well. Alright, so we got ceiling tiles. Nice. I got plenty of stone, not enough wood to do much else, so we're going to go ahead and transfer the stone back over. Yeah, I'll do the ceiling tiles back in. Yeah, this way we can move around a little bit longer. Alright, glue, follow us. We're going to go grab some more stone. We got three ceilings, we got two walls. We're going to use at least probably another set of walls. We might want to get a dino gate and a ramp to get the trike on so we'll have some protection wherever we go. I'm thinking I want the ramp on the boat. Another thought would be to build a ramp to the top of the boat. That way dinos can ride on the top and the inside will be left clear. That might be the better way to go. Alright, we got a scope. We're going to scope out this dillo. It's always nice to have dillos. That way you can get, ooh, level 8. Alright, I want my slingshot or the club. Let's go with the club and I'll bolo him. Alright. Make sure that our dino is on passive, that we don't kill this thing. And we'll knock her in place. There's sidestep so we don't get hit by anything. I'm going to hit that 7 key to get us the club. And then we're going to say goodnight to this dillo. Alright, so she's out for the count. And we're going to let her just wake up on her own. That's right. If she wakes up, it's fine. She just, she'll be hungry when she wakes up. And then we can knock her out again and then give her the food and she will be immediately tamed. Sun's going down. Over this way, it's hard to see right now because of the sun's place, but that is where the death happens. Raptors and carnotaurs come running down through there. So make our way back over these trees. We're not in too much danger now that we got glue to protect. Oh my goodness, I broke my metal axe. That means I'm down to collecting with a standard axe here. So the standard axe is not going to collect as much wood from the same resources. It'll still crack the tree down just as fast, I think. Maybe a little bit slower, but you still get a fair amount of wood. 12 wood off of that one tree. Versus maybe 20. And anywhere you can get a stronger axe that has a higher melee damage on it, the more resource collection you'll have. And if you actually put points into melee damage, you'll collect more from the same tool. Grant, so I don't have to let the Dilophosaurus wake up. If she does, that's fine. Again, I just knock her out again. I can preempt her waking up by going over there and clubbing her a little bit more. Alright, we got 120 wood, and we want more walls at this point, so let's go ahead and collect this stone. We got two walls, we want to probably at least have five to get started here. Alright, so the walls are further down, and if I can't find it quick enough, you can always just type in wall, or start to type in wall in the search. You can see that I can make four. Let's go ahead and make all four of those. And we'll get back to collecting while that's crafting. So crafting your stone, it gets you your building, you know, your your base, or if you're working on a raft like we are, it'll help get that going quicker, and it'll also throw you experience, right? So you want to go ahead and work on things that you need. Like, I'm taming this Dillo, but I'm only taming it because it happened to be a female, low level, and in the area that I'm working. So kind of try to get multiple threads going at the same time. You see it's on its way to waking up. It's still not, it's about half hungry. So we're going to beat it out unconscious again. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I break my club. All right, so looking at it, it's at full unconsciousness. It's at maybe 70% health. And I'm not worried about losing taming effectiveness on a Dilophosaurus. That's level 8. Instead of getting maybe two levels, you'll only get one. And if I keep beating her, she might maybe drop to 0 bonus levels, which is fine because I'm only getting her for her eggs. Those Dilophosaurus eggs will be used in Kibble for Dodecarus, the stone-collecting mammal on Ark. And we get the saddle for that at level 30, which is what we're approaching right now. We want to find ourselves a low-level Dodeco in the near future. And that stone collection will help us gain in levels, again, to get to level 35, at which point we get our Pteranodon. And that opens up all the carnivores, all the carnivore taming, rather, that is, because you get prime meat off of a high-level Pteranodon by attacking various critters, like Stegosaurus. Stegosaurus, you can even go after Brontos if you get your Pteranodon strong enough. Alright, so we've got ourselves heavy again. We're going to go ahead and throw the walls on the trike here. And we're going to have to collect some more wood. We got the stone. Here's some wood here. I also noticed I had about 300 narco berries on me. Let's transfer those over. So the stone does respawn. You go through an area, you clear out the stone, you work on some trees, and by the time you come back around, you'll have the stone there again for you, so you can just continue to craft as you go. Hunt down anything that's around you. Might as well take what the Ark provides. Another nice thing to get to level 30, I think it's 30 for the sickle, the scythe for collecting fiber from bushes. You won't get any berries, but you'll cut through the plants really fast and get lots and lots of fiber. Alright, so we got stone walls. Why don't we go ahead and make ourselves... What do you want? Whoop, I put the stuff on you, didn't I? Alright. So I have 78 stone, I have just 20 wood. Wow, I thought I had... Well, no, 120 wood. Okay, so what am I missing? I'm probably missing thatch. And rather than collecting the thatch by hand, I'm going to use the trike to get the thatch. Because you can use the pick to get thatch, but look at this, 27 thatch already. Knock down that. I get some wood, and I also get some berries in the vicinity that I'm collecting from, so just spam that trike button against those trees. So it's not as fast as the axe in collecting of wood, but you can see you get plenty of resources just by whacking away on this. So we got some thatch here. Go ahead and grab that thatch and the wood, and now we should be able to craft that which we would desire. And what do we want here? We want, is it ceilings? Let's do the ramp. Probably want some of these. Let's go ahead and do two ramps. It's requiring the wood. Those are pretty intensive for the need on wood. So axe gives you wood, and the pick will get you the thatch. So if we switch over to the pick, you can see focus on getting more thatch that way, but I prefer the trike for collection. Don't break your weapons that way. You get plenty of thatch. Let's head over to that Dillo. Dillo ought to be waking up very soon, if not already. There's the Dillo in front of us. It's a little dark, but I can see it on the ground there. Dillo is... oh my god, it's about to wake. Okay, let's give it the meat. I only have 5. And it's hungry, very hungry. So let's go ahead and grab some meat off of you. If you got 20, should be plenty to tame you. Alright, so now we got 20 meat on the Dillo. You can see how its taming bars is shooting up. Every bite, it jumps about, I'd say about 10%. Alright, so it's full now, so I'm going to want to beat it unconscious again. And it got health back while it was eating. Alright, so it's at full unconsciousness. Go ahead and keep on collecting. It's got enough meat now on it that it'll auto-tame on its own. And we got a green drop coming down. To put some more points in weight, huh? Well, I had a fair amount. I'm gonna transfer over some stuff, keep it fresh. I don't really need these pipes on my body. Not that I do. Alright, we'll keep collecting as we go here. If we see another Dilophosaur female, that'd be nice to pick up some more as we go. So a very quiet area. So if you're looking for a location on the island that you can set up shop and not have too many things attacking you all at once, that would be West Zone 2. It'll spawn you pretty much where we're standing right now. And then if you head further east and north, you'll find yourself hitting up against lots and lots of meat eaters and things coming after you and trying to kill you. But if you hang around here and this whole thicket of trees, even though it looks a little scary, this thicket is relatively devoid of critters. I don't think they spawn in there at all. It's just they wander in there. You might find yourself fighting raptors and carnotaurus and the whatnot. So if you are on a server with other players and you don't want them destroying anything of yours, you could always just leave the door open and not have anything of value in there. With a hardcore server, you need to log out in a secure spot. But if I've got something like that raft right there, and I don't want anybody coming along and destroying it, well, if I leave the door open and I don't have anything of value, they'll come in, they'll look around, they'll open up the boxes. If I have them pin-coded, they're going to break them. If I don't pin code them, they can access them, and then they're just going to look, and then they're going to leave. They're not going to, I mean, they might destroy it, but the chances are probably significantly reduced. If they've come, they saw, they know there's nothing of value, they move on. It saves you time in rebuilding, and you're going to want to take your stuff off your raft, too, unless you're living there. And if you're living there, you don't want to leave it in some obvious spot like that. You're going to want to stick it away, maybe out to sea. Thank you. if you have trouble seeing at night, you can modify your gamma settings. It's really easy if you've got an NVIDIA display card. Just right-click on, open up your NVIDIA control, and then you want to change your gamma. The higher the gamma, the brighter it's going to be, make it easier for you to see in the game. And a lot of video cards, they have different default gammas, what their 1.0 is. So I end up with a NVIDIA 980M, for this is a laptop I'm playing on. It runs real smooth. Yeah, so you know, with that, it got really dark when I shifted over to the 980M, and I just couldn't see at night at all. Even with a torch in front of me, I could see maybe 3 or 4 feet, so now we're in a better place. Alright, so we had some ramps. We got 2 of those ramps. I'm thinking we probably want more walls. Could always do with more walls, because we can get higher that way. We also want to get to a point where we can have maybe... Yeah, that's why we decided against the dino gate. So let's go ahead and do 5 walls, and that should be... pretty good. We'll make these walls, throw them back on the trike for safekeeping. We've got only 13 stone left. We've got 11 walls, so let's go ahead and collect a little bit more. I'm going to make a doorway. And what do you think? One in the front, one in the back, or just one in the front? Maybe one on the roof to get out up on top. That might be a good idea too. So I make a hatch. So we're going to want 1 stone hatch. We're going to need some more ceilings if we're putting the dino on top. We're going to need some ceilings. Could make the ceilings out of wood, but again, probably better just to collect the stone for it. That green drop landed, so why don't we go over there? We got the dillo tamed. Don't want that thing dying either. So we'll come back for that after we get the green drop. Alright, so this is going to get a little bit risky, and I'm low on water. I don't want to outpace the trike too much, and he will get stuck on rocks and things. I just don't want this thing despawning before I get there. There's the water bar. Alright, so now that I'm thirsty, I won't regain any stamina as I'm sprinting until I drink. Alright, so we got a wood structure. We'll go ahead and take that, and we're going to make it back over to our trike, run past him, and we'll go ahead and sprint. We should have enough energy to make it to the water. Just don't want, you know, watching those stars in the top or on the right hand side mid area. You see the hands coming up grabbing stuff. As I'm sprinting while I'm thirsty, I'm also getting close to getting knocked out. So I'm going to drink that water. Might even fill up my water skin. Here we go. Just click it and then use item. You could also put it on your hotbar. Go ahead and take our new dillo back towards a safer location. And she's got some meat on her. I'm going to go ahead and take that away. Got a white drop coming down. So that's another good reason to pick up the drops. I think it increases the speed at which the next spawn will come down. I'm thinking it might be nice to head over to that boat and build out these few pieces I've got here. I'm thinking 2 walls high and big inside. That would give me the ability to stick goodies inside. Maybe a cabinet, refining forges, smithy. Went and got heavy. We don't have much wood, do we? 20 wood, 100 stone, so we'll shift the stone over. I could get wood back very quickly here with this stuff. Let's go ahead and make ourselves a structure here. So So I'm going to go ahead and plant that down. I'm going to build the walls. What's cold? You want water? Cold water? All right, buddy. I'll get you some cold water. All right, and then we'll get the ceiling, the door, and the doorway. So we've got to put this here. Boom. And I'll use the door frame. Same way as before. Go ahead and demolish that. Want to demolish the door. And we'll go ahead and build that on top. Demolish that straight away. And this is, you know, we're collecting tons of wood here. You see that? 30 wood for that. Picked up another 15 here. This will be about 40. And 55. Holy smokes. No, it's the 40 plus the 15. It's just adding them together. Alright, so now that we got all that wood, I think we wanted ceiling, so let me go ahead and grab some of those. Do we have any thatch left on you? Nope. And that's okay. We wanted a hatch frame. And we wanted a door frame. And a door. And I think we needed some ceilings too, but we don't have enough stone for that. So I'm going to transfer this over. I'm groaning and moaning over here because I have not eaten much. So I'm going to go over here, take a look at the berries. What do we got? We got 22 of these. Let's go ahead and throw that on. Gobble those up. We got 42 of the red ones. That ought to sate the hunger. Another 30 blue. Alright, so we're good to go on that. We'll go ahead and collect some more stone. And did the white land? Yes, it did. Let's run over there. So the nice thing about white drops is they give you a lot of basic resources a lot of times. They'll give you a thatch room, which is pretty much garbage, or cloth armor. But sometimes you'll get lucky. We did not. I'm going to hold the O key as I hover over these. Drops everything. Boom. And there's, I think, probably also a drop all button. Those guys are chilling out over there. Alright, so I should have lots of wood already. And we got a tad more thatch probably here too. But let's go ahead and grab some more stone. And we'll work our way over to the raft and we'll go ahead and put the pieces we've got on it. So I'm just grabbing, just pushing E as I walk around. So I'm traveling and gathering. You always want to do more than one thing in life and in your gaming. You don't want to just concentrate on doing one thing when you could be doing multiple. So tame dinosaurs while crafting. Tame multiple dinosaurs while taming dinosaurs. If you want an ankylosaur, why settle for one? Why not go for multiple? I mean, if you're kibble taming it, great. You only have enough kibble for that one particular guy. I understand. Do one. But while you're doing that one, maybe there's some dillos, maybe there's some dimorphodons, maybe there's something in the area that you want alongside that. Don't just stand there next to one dinosaur crafting, or rather waiting for that thing to tame. Get on out there. Use that time to enjoy the game and other aspects at the same time. And then if you need to, I know I do sometimes, need to almost have like a list of what you're focused on. That way you can just take a glance at that every few minutes, make sure you're doing what's on that list. Because sometimes you'll knock out that Dilophosaurus and be like, oh man, I got a Dilophosaurus taming. I need to run back and make sure that guy is still knocked out, or find him and knock him out again. If your dinosaur wakes up and you haven't fed it any food, no harm done. It's hungry now. Knock it out again and it'll eat instantly. Or if it hasn't used up its food yet, let it sit knocked out again until it wakes up. The only risk you have is it might be waking up and then either despawning if you're not in the area, or getting killed by another dinosaur. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and throw the ingredients onto our trike here, make our way back over to the raft. And then I'll build what I need to as I go. So this is the backside. Muted while I had to cough there for a second. Alright, so we are going to build these off the backside. And hopefully we can build some walls on top here. So if I go on the inside, I won't have to rotate the key for it. I'm going to tell these guys to stop following. You can push the apostrophe button and then whistle stop all. Now these guys aren't following me. They won't get all crazy like. All right, I'm going to try something out here. Build here. And I'm going to want to build the stone doorway here. But I want to make sure that the ramp can come off the back of that and make it down so that the trike can get up on the back side of it. Go ahead and stuff that poo in here for later. Gotta love some poo. Alright, why don't we stick that on top of the berry location, and we'll build a wall. Doorway here. Alright, so we're too high. It's a pretty high boat. I'm gonna go ahead and grab the ramps and hope and pray that we can get this ramp to come off the back and land where we need it. Alright, I'm wanting it to come off the top. And it looks like I can get it off the top. I'm just going to need to get higher up. So I'm going to use my mobile ladder here. Alright, I want it to come off. A little hokey here with the snap points. Alright, so this is where I want it. Boom. You know what? You're right, boy. Let me make you that water cold real quick. I'm just going to put some ice and water in a cup. So we got one ramp off the back. That's not going to be good enough. Please let me put two. Oh, requires nearby foundation support. Not cool. All right, so unfortunately I cannot do that. I'm going to have to go here, and then I can put a ceiling on the other side. I'm thinking, if I can only do one here, then I probably won't do one. It won't let me do one the other way. This is going to have to get demolished. And that's sad. That's very sad. But we can, since we used up stuff on this side. If we made the wall here, it's not ideal, but I could demolish this one stone ceiling, and then I could put this like that, and then another one up here, and now this should let me get down to the ground once I make another one of these. Do I have the resources? Boom, boom, and boom. There we go. Alright, so now this guy is probably not going to want to climb up that ramp, is he? Let's see. Alright, he is. Okay, so now I can get him up on top. Not bad. And on you are the ceiling. No ceilings? I didn't make ceilings. Okay. So I can use that as a means of him getting up on top. I'll go ahead and put the doorway down, put the ceilings down that I've got. Not ceilings, but the walls here. Boom. Boom. And we got one in the back. We're going to have one in the front. I don't need one in the back, do I? No, I don't. Okay, so I'm going to actually convert this into a wall. Alright. So I'm going to have one in the front and one on the ceiling. That's what I'm going to do. So I have that one in the front there. Now why did you turn around? It's because I had a foundations there. Can't place wall. Wall's obstructed. Alright, well, do we care that it looks a little funky? Maybe. Alright, so here we go. We got that one. And I'm not too happy with the way this one looks. Cosmetics count, right? So we'll go ahead and build that up. So our boat's coming together pretty nicely now. I'll figure out where I want to stick that other ceiling piece. And we can make a ceiling there, and I'm going to make some more walls. Make two more walls. We are now level 30. Congratulations. We got 200 weight. We got 290 health. We got some more points to spend. Alright, so let's go ahead and build. That's the way we want the wall to look. Alright, so we will put another wall here eventually. But we're high up, we'll be able to break out through here, have the ceilings up on top, plenty of room inside this base. Just hope that I don't run out of space on the boat. I think I should be fine. Not keeping count right now. Alright, so we'll grab those stone and wood, and we'll come back and, we'll have it too high, pretty wide inside, have a lot of room to move around, be comfortable. I think it's important to be too high in the backside. Might be one high in the front side if necessary. But being too high, too wall high on that, it'll keep the dinosaurs from taking damage from anything apart from maybe like a trike. There's not a trike, like a rex size or a spinosaurus. And we will be going in the river, so trike might get beat up on by a spino. Be careful with that. So I left that Dilla over there by the boat. She's fine. She's not going to get attacked by anything over there. So I'm more likely that we'd get attacked by something out here, and I wouldn't be able to protect the Dilla. Trike would save me. Alright. Got another green drop over there. It's coming down on that high hill. I'm not going to go that far out. I got a parasaur out there in the distance in the tree line. So on a hardcore server, you always got to be scanning for dinosaurs, any movement in the tree lines, anything that could move up on you. Fortunately, I'm only having to look one direction right now, into that up there in the tree line, this area section where I'm looking at. And we're collecting the stone. Almost full here on stone. And as we're getting heavy, we'll go ahead and toss that back on the trike. And I think I wanted the ceilings now, so let's go ahead and... What am I missing for ceilings? We want to have more thatch. Head on over to the trees. And this is where we hop on you, Miss Glue. This is where it's counterintuitive that these big trees take one hit, they go down, and they only give about 9 to 10. It's stacking up, that's why it's saying 34. I'm not actually collecting that much per swing. It's just accumulating. These two trees right here ought to give a lot. So we'll take that thatch and that wood, and we'll go ahead and craft some ceilings here. You get two of them. A lot of thatch, but we need the thatch anyway because we've got some plants growing back at the base that we want to keep the fertilizer compost bins going. So stone's the way to go. If you build something out of wood, like a wooden raft with wooden foundations and everything else, first time you find yourself being attacked by a sarco, you're going to be regretting it because it's going to chew through that wood. Those sarcos, they attack you potentially even in swarms. You got titan bows coming at you. You'll be finding spinos. Spinos can't eat through the stone, but they will destroy that ramp off the back. So a metal boat would be better, but that's a lot of resources to put on a boat. Depends on what you're using it for, I guess. I'm going to be pretty happy with just a stone boat. Only thing that I can break through would be a Gigantosaurus. And I'll be in big trouble. I'll never be able to run one of those, so might just sacrifice the trike to survive that one. Make our way back up. All right, well, that'll do it for now. Appreciate you guys watching.